and I'm about to go to my holy hour, so I thought I'd share a little bit about the day in the life of a FOCUS missionary.
This is St. Peter's Catholic Church, where the missionaries and I pray about 3 to 4 times a week together. We pray our daily holy hour here, and it's just so beautiful and peaceful.
This is the student chapel at the Catholic Center on campus, and it's just great for students because it's so accessible because it's right on campus, and it's a peaceful place for students to go and pray and have access to whenever they need.
In our Bible study, we ask the question, who am I? What am I made for? And then in our second chapter, we asked, who do you say that I am? Which is the question that Jesus asks Peter, who do you say that I am? Then we went over the cross and what it actually means that Jesus died on the cross. And then we learned about the covenant and what it truly means to be a part of the covenant family of God. And finally, we learned about the prodigal son and how our Father is just waiting for us with open arms, waiting for us to be truly in eternal peace with him, in a home with him forever. This is the prayer challenge. It was a 6-week-long challenge of praying through the book of Luke together. It was just me and one of the students named Angie. And it was a really great opportunity to place Christ at the center of our life. This is my friend Teresa, and her and I get together every week and read a book called The Catholic Table. And it's just a book about looking at food in a new sacramental way. Miguel, Ella, Noah, Kathleen, Bibi, and me. Oh, and that's Jonathan. My very first long-distance bike ride. It was from Greeley and then along the Poudre River Trail all the way to Windsor, so it was about 17 miles. And this was Our Lady of the Valley Catholic Church in Windsor, and I had never been there before, and it was beautiful, so it was really cool to stop and pray my holy hour there. Friends and family and missionary partners, I am so grateful for this whole entire semester, and I could not have done it without my prayer warriors and my mission partners, and so
I'm just so grateful to make this video, and also I just want to end this by reading a psalm, because at this time of year we've all experienced some type of impact by the coronavirus, and we're probably going into the Christmas season also having some anxiety towards whether family can come home or not. And so I decided to read Psalm 121 because I was listening to a meditation last week. It's an Advent meditation by the Ascension Presents program. It's an online program that provides different Bible studies and different talks about prayer life and all that good stuff. And so they're doing an Advent 4-week program right now, and their very first one focused on just Mother Mary and Saint Joseph in the little inn, you know, just in kind of their own fear and their own poverty. And so the meditation says something about Saint Joseph saying the words of Psalm 121 to Mother Mary, and I just wanted to look that up, and so I looked it up, and it really is the perfect psalm to trust in the Lord, to trust in Him as our Father and our caretaker and as the all-powerful, loving God who just doesn't abandon us no matter what is happening. So I'm just going to read that to you, and I pray that you have a Merry Christmas and a wonderful new year, and I am excited to just continue to keep up with you and reach out to you for prayers. My voice is a little bit stuffy. I did get a little bit sick, and I'm waiting on test results, but I know that I'm doing fine, and I am being taken care of very well by my wonderful fellow missionaries and the wonderful women I live with right now. So again, thank you for your love and care, and I will just pray through Psalm 121 with you. God bless. I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither sleep nor slumber. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore.